dire wa crazy or talk crazy or what type of crazy is that except crazy
news making the headlines.
Black Maria is to carry criminals, trading looters that are in government today.
Sometimes it gets confrontational.
Slap you in the face.
Kill me, don't put words into my mouth.
Whatever it is that will bring our military to discipline. I said, oh, hell
on me. Cold Digest.
I want to know why I should be believing them.
Every weekday, we bring all of these together and take them to the court of public opinion.
Everybody have your right in Nigeria.
Where you are the judge.
Good to have you back. It's still Cold Digest Extra on Cold TV News, and we actually apologize for that long break. We had to set some things in order, and so we just want to continue on where we last stopped. And interestingly, we still have the career and business coach in the house. Of course, just him, as he continue on where he stopped on how to build a successful career. Of course, even if you're not so entrepreneurial savvy and you don't know how to start a business of your own, how can you remain in that job and survive the hard economic times in the country? So, Gbenga Rufai, over to you. We're saying something new all the time.
Yes, before we went on that break,
we're
talking about how do you stay relevant. You made mention of a company, quoted me, that lead of 50% an indigenous manufacturer in Nigeria. So the question then is, how do I stay relevant in my career? And I said a key driver is continuous improvement. And I said to you that research came out and said every technology gets obsolete within 2 years, which tells you that between the first year of a university entry student to the fourth year, whatever he learned within those 2 years is obsolete by the time he's leaving. And so as a result of that, the responsibility then has shifted to the employee to remain relevant and carve a niche for yourself. And the reason is that the career landscape has changed. Employers no longer pay you for the time you sit on the job. They pay you for the value you contribute to the job. And so as an HR consultant, one of the things that we do is we do a critical talent analysis, which tells you that some employees are critical talent to the organization. Some are non-critical. It doesn't mean they're not relevant, but what it's saying is that these critical talents are those that drive the organization. Without them, we are nowhere. And it's not a question of hierarchy, because, for instance, you could have a senior manager who is not a critical talent and have someone who is an officer who is a critical talent. For instance, I have an administrative officer in your organization, administrative manager. Your HR department could do a critical talent analysis and say the camera operators are more critical than the administrative manager. In terms of hierarchy, the administrative manager seems up there, but in terms of being critical to the survival of the organization, the cameramen are more critical. And so the responsibility for you as an employee is to keep on improving yourself and say to yourself, what relevant domain knowledge must I have, not academic knowledge? Because you could have the academic qualifications, but you are not able to do, and that's a major challenge. They can say it, but they cannot do it, which are two different things. And so for you to remain relevant, you must carve a niche by continuously improving yourself. What is the latest technology? What is the latest trend in my industry? How are things being done? We've moved from absolutely saying only industrial relations, we are now talking about employee relations. We've moved from analog, we are talking about digital. The way you used to report as a reporter 5 years down the line is different from the way you report now. You must have digital editing skills, which means we could send you to the Middle East to cover a story. There is nobody in the editing room to come and edit your news for you there. What you must be able to do is power up your laptop and you're able to edit and file in.
And so the question is adding value.
Adding value, yes.
Adding value.
Absolutely.
And you know, of course, with the economic times here, a lot of people will still say, there are no jobs there. I can do this, I can do that, but I'm not getting this job. But you know, interestingly, on the older end, you find out that some organizations are saying, oh, we need people. And you're wondering, what's happening here? This moment, there's no job. The next moment, we're looking for people to employ. And you know, I really do not want to subscribe to the school of thought that they are unemployable graduates.
That's not true.
So what do you think could be done to actually balance that lacuna?
The challenge is that the amount of available openings, it's far, far less than the amount of available graduates, which means supply is more than the demand.
All right.
For instance, you advertise for a role and you say you want an entry-level officer in a bank, just 5 openings. You are likely to get well over 1,000 CVs. So the question then is the survival of the fittest?
Mm-hmm.
So the first step then is, how do I even get to the door? The first thing that will get you to the door is your qualification, is the proof that you have the qualification. You get to the door, then you get to the interview. Is what can you do differently?
Okay. And so for entrepreneurs, since you've actually helped those in career, of course you're a business developer, so how could entrepreneurs also survive these times?
Let me just clarify. I wear 2 caps. I also work with businesses.
Okay.
I also work primarily as an HR consultant. What do entrepreneurs need to survive at this time? Earlier, before we went to the break, we were talking about innovation.
Yeah.
It's to understand that every challenging situation, when you look closely, presents to you a veiled opportunity. And so you ask yourself the question, despite all the problems we talk about in Nigeria, why do we still have people coming to invest? The reason is that they understand that we have the population, and that creates an opportunity. Every problem is usually an opportunity, just veiled. And so entrepreneurs will be able to look closely and think creatively. What else can I do different? Entrepreneurs, depending on the industry or what they're currently doing, must be able to say to themselves, how can I leverage technology? Because for all you care, the middle class form the bulk of Nigeria's population and is a highly consuming population.
Okay.
And so you're saying to yourself, is what can I do differently? The working class, how can I leverage technology to drive my business? What opportunities are there for me to leverage? What need? And you must realize, not luxury needs now, because people have moved away from luxury. For instance, the dollar is exchanging well over 300 naira. So it's not a question of luxury. It's a question of daily need. Okay. With or without it, they will need it.
All right. Now, we would just like to take calls very quickly, of course, before we round off this segment. And so if you have a question for Binga Rufai, who is a career and business coach on the program today, and of course, a HR consultant, who also doubles as a social commentator, feel free to ask your questions or contributions on the topic today, austerity in 2016, surviving the times. Or if there's an experience you want to share, feel free to call in on the program and would be glad to take your call to listen to that contribution you have on the program. And so just as we continue with you, Binga Rufai, we actually started from the fight against corruption. You know, we went through insecurity and now we're talking economy and stuff. And so how soon do you see Nigeria overcoming these times, really?
That's a very big question. Let's not kid ourselves. It's not going to come as quickly as we want it. But the thing that I expect from the leadership of the country, and I'm saying that across board, from the governors to the National Assembly to the executive and the judiciary, is you must be able to maintain a level of confidence amongst the populace, which means I must listen to you in the midst of the crisis and still have a measure of confidence that things will still work out well. Your body language, your policies must keep on reassuring investors. When Christine Lagarde was in Nigeria, the IMF boss, one of the things that people said, maybe she's not saying the entire truth of our mission here in Nigeria, was that she said, oh, Nigeria doesn't need to borrow. What was she trying to do in essence? I see it as a tactical way to still build investor confidence in coming into Nigeria.
Okay.
That we get our act right. Virtually every nation at one time in the other has gone through problems. Yes, their problems might not be ours in the 21st century, but we're saying that we still have what it takes to come out. It may take long, and let's be frank with ourselves, we are in for the long haul.
Hmm.
We are in for the long haul.
And so do you see Nigerians as supportive and ready to carry on with these times? Are we that dogged to survive these times?
Nigerians are resilient people. They are resilient, they are dogged. They have the ability to build or grow around challenges. For instance, there's a challenge in a particular area. You just, before you snap your finger, you see Nigerians come up with ideas and say, this is the way we can circumvent the system. Come up with a new innovation. In less than a month or two, you will see creative people that will say, no, we can do it in a better way. So I see the Nigerian person as, an average Nigerian person as being resilient, highly dexterous, can work hard, where they want to work hard. And so we have what it takes as a nation to rise out of whatever challenge we are currently facing. We are not going to be the first to go through that problem. The history is replete with nations that went through worse times like ours. But I believe that with time, maybe take long, but we're going to come out as a nation.
Okay, well, very good. That's quite encouraging there. So as we round off this particular segment now, of course, austerity measures, you know, there are two different schools of people. We have those who complain about the problem. We have those who try to look for a solution to that problem and have a headway or overcome that particular challenge. So, like, in the way of an advice to viewers watching us, of course, on the economic front line, on the impatience about how the president should do something quick to turn the whole country around, what would be your word of advice generally?
My word of advice is keep hope alive. Stay relevant. Keep moving. Don't dither. Don't stop. There are challenges, yes, but think creatively. How can I overcome the challenge? Where is the gold in the midst of the challenge? Stay at it. And my word of advice for entrepreneurs is this. While we are on the break, I quickly said to him, I said that there is a bit of a challenge with Nigerian entrepreneurs. Is most entrepreneurs set out to start up businesses and not start up organizations. They are two different things. And that is why we have that large amount of SMEs, millions of them registered SMEs. But the problem is they never transit from small businesses to large organizations. A major lever that transits a small business to organization is the use of processes. Most businesses don't value process, how things should be done. And that is why such businesses never outlive them. That's why you have the high mortality rate within 2 years. Yes, the system has a problem. There's no enabling environment, but still within your own small business, have a value for system and processes. It's a question of time that things will get better and you can access the right financing. Most banks, BOI and the likes, there are opportunities there. Yes, not always attractive, but the opportunities, but they require basic documentation. We must be able to see that it is not only just a business, it's going somewhere. There are records. But an average SME doesn't have a record. It doesn't have a record. And so it's difficult for you to access grants. It's difficult for you to access opportunities. It's difficult for you to retain good employees. Because sometimes you have large people who are willing to work with you. They come on board, but they see that the business is going nowhere. They will leave. And so businesses must be able to create an environment for their talents to thrive. They must be able to create an environment where the employees, yes, it's an SME today, but we believe it's going to go somewhere. If I ask you a question, Tayo, do you know those that started PricewaterhouseCoopers? Do you know Arthur Henderson? Do you know Henry Ford? Do you know all those names? They are names of people that started businesses but have become large corporations today. Processes is key. Doing the right things, creating an enabling environment for your talent to thrive. And that was a question of time I'm going to get on.
Well, I think we'd love to have you back talk on building industries, because a lot of people say that's what is lacking in this country, where a business starts up and in the next 2 years you don't hear anything about it. And that's clearly a waste of resources and human power and human resources too at the same time, seeing that what you started with is no longer in existence. But really, it's really a pleasure having you on the program, being Arufai.
Thank you, sir.
So it's we would like you to join us later.
Sure.
Like I said. All right. You're still on to Call Digest Extra. The program is not over yet. Of course, Benga Arufai and the guest earlier, John Kome, actually did justice to how we could survive these times. And so the question is, do you want to belong to the school that always complain about a problem and become worse off? Or that school, who will take up that challenge and see that such problems are overcome? So stay with us on the program and we'll bring you more on the program as we move to the entertainment segment, where I have a chit chat with a gospel artist. On the program, his name is Jay Decent. Stay with us and we'll be right back.
For topical issues, Nigerians must have something to say.
Arms, we don't need arms for anything. Let them put it into education.
They need to buy another arms now.
What are they fighting for?
Wait, what?
Who?
Government should deal with them squarely.
Please, help us bring back our
our guests. No money, no markets. We are dying. Everybody is crying. Nothing, nothing.
Any man God support, no man stops.
It's a prophecy I believe he must have received from heaven.
Yes.
The people giving voice to the voiceless.
You can now watch Core TV News live from anywhere in the world on our website, www.coretvnews.com. Click on Live TV on our website and watch us live.
And welcome to Core TV Primetime News.
To follow us on Twitter, click on Twitter icon on our website. And Facebook, click on the Facebook. And YouTube to see all our previous news production. You can also watch us live on YouTube. Click Core TV. Leave a space, then news. Core TV News, a 24-hour news station.
Oh yeah.
Get this in.
Oh, you draw a real.
And you're supposed to know my name is Benji. I read on Corey.
You can call me for your highness, multi take over. Many days for the hustle, many days for the struggle. You visit me right now, man. I done the bubble, many days for the rich, many days for the poor. You got gone, we'll slave me. But I did for you, me not good, cause you want shabby. Many go cause good, move for your EB. I begin in, so I have a good beginning. Every time you share head, move your shape beginning. But I get your skinny shoe filler. Move my panora, I won't go digger. And you're not off. This is my last cover. You want some fun, brother? Asa,
I read on Kore.
All right, that was the song of Jay Decent, Boluwatife Adigbo, Agbola, actually, Boluwatife Agbola. You know, that was one of his music video. Of course, you know, I said it's a gospel artist, but also he does hip-hop too, and that song is Ebila. And we have the author and singer of Ebila, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so what inspired that song, really?
Yeah, I was in my room one day. I was just thinking of what I could do that could be special from what I've been doing before. So I thought of a prayerful song. So I was just like, I'm in a Corey, Afoyaibi is a very good prayer that will walk through success, will overcome the any evil thing that is coming before us. So, and I came right and came.
Ebila.
Ebila.
So what does Ebila mean?
So Ebila means enemies should move away.
What language is that?
It's just a Yoruba slang.
Ebila.
But it's not all these South songs, it's slang.
Okay.
But Yoruba slang.
Yoruba slang. I've never heard it before. I'm Yoruba as well, but it's interesting that I've not heard Ebila before. But, you know, that's on one side. So how long have you been singing, Jay Decent?
About 4 years now.
4 years. And so you started off as a gospel artist, then you went into hip-hop. Okay. And so I would like to know more about you. Of course, what course did you study? Did you study music in school to actually come up with this?
No. I study computer science engineering.
Okay.
Engineering in Lautech, Ladoke Akintola University.
All right.
So I'm in undergrad level right now. Into 200 person.
Wow.
So I had that talent while I was very young. I knew I could sing, you understand? So I started having the feeling when I was in secondary school. So I started composing. I mean, when I was in secondary school, I started composing, and I did my first track was Bebesti the Flow.
Okay.
So, and the track was a massive hit in my school. Everybody knew me. They loved this track, so I kept it. I kept on going.
Mm.
So.
Well, really, a computer engineer, right?
Yeah.
To a music artist, how do you combine both?
People used to say it's not easy, but to me, it's quite easy.
Okay.
Because my music has never affected my education at all. Because there are times to read. I don't read most of the time because there are some students, they read every single free period they have to read. But mine is not that way. And when I'm composing too, I don't compose almost every time. The little period I have, when the inspiration comes.
Mm.
So that is when I do the track. So, and the time for me to read is quite different from time for me to compose my track. And times for shows is different from time for school.
Okay.
So they are really different.
Okay.
So to me, it's very easy for me.
Okay.
Well, it has not been easy for some people, but to me, it's easy because, and my school supports entertainment.
All right.
So that's it.
Okay, and so the question is, you know, different artists have their different sources of inspiration and how they get their song. You know, some would say, you know, you just mentioned that you were sleeping or so, and you got the inspiration for Ebila.
Yeah.
But if you were going to look at what is the most common period you get inspiration for songs, when would that be?
When I'm about to sleep.
Okay.
When I'm about to sleep, because you know, before you sleep you relax first.
Okay.
Things will run through your mind. So that is how I used to get my inspiration. So the things that goes through my mind is what I'm thinking, I would just like, let me make it a song. As I'm talking right now, I can make song it.
Really? Oh, definitely you do that for us before you go. But let's just continue to, for you as an up-and-coming music artist, what would you consider the most challenging experience for you?
The most challenging experience is the show issue. As in, you know, we're upcoming, we've not been getting paid like the top celebrities. So we are still fighting. I'm still fighting to get there. You understand? So I'm still struggling. So taking my music to TV stations, radio stations, the expenses, and going to school, that's the hard aspect for me.
Mm-hmm.
So the expenses, how I manage myself with the little income
that you have.
With the little income, so it has not been easy. So that's the challenges.
And so, from what you said now, it's not been so easy for you, but you still do it. So what is that driving force for you?
Yeah, it's the ambition. As in,
to become the next pop star.
To become the next top star, next top.
Become the next Olamide or the next who?
No, that's an insult.
Oh, really?
That's an insult.
Okay, to become the next what?
The next Jay Dee Sent.
Wow, it's Jay Dee Sent. That's quite interesting, really. And so, for you, what would be your word of advice to those like you, up-and-coming artists? Of course, you started in 2012, and you've seen a lot, really. And so, if you were to recount the experiences you've had, what would be the lesson you'd like to push out for those who are passionate about music, just like you, despite all odds, you're still doing what you love? So what is that message you'd like them to take home?
Yeah, I would advise fellow artists like me that are still on the street to keep it on, to keep going. Well, because that's not been easy. Some people, it's not that they really have the talent, but they just want to be famous, you understand? So I would advise those people, if they want to be famous, there are other ways to be. But if you know you have the talent and you really have the passion for it, just keep it on, keep on going, and don't be lazy.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be lazy at what you do. Because there are some people that are supposed to be there right now, but because of laziness, some people do tracks, they can't even afford, it's not they can't afford, to drop money to promote their track. They can't do it. They do track and perform in a local staging local business. So I would just advise my fellow artists to just keep it on. Just think higher. Expand your mentality, as in your vision. Think about it. What do you want to become? Do you want to become a musician? Just, if you know that's what you want to become, just keep it up. Never give up. And don't forget school as well.
Okay.
Still the most important thing.
Yeah, very interesting. And so very importantly is the fact that, you know, just like the first segment we had, we're looking at austerity measures in 2016, surviving the times. You know, a lot of youth especially would complain about unemployment,
yeah,
getting out of school with no job. Some who have job, the salary rarely takes them home. And so if you were going to say something about how those out there could survive these times until things become a whole lot better, what would be that message for them?
The message for them, I'll tell them not to give up. Because all this employment issue is kind of hard, that's true. But when you are destined to do great things, what will be yours will never pass you by. So that's what I believe. I believe that time will come. So, thank you very much.
All right. you know, it's so interesting that you think and you're sounding all calm, cool and collected. I hope you are not just trying to show
or
form calmness.
No,
all right. So we'd like you to do something for us. Bolu Atife Agbola.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum omo kiyanyi jomo. Jedi sent lomba yin soro ye jomo. Iris mi gun gan ile jina si somo bi mo shen rap she fiu mi e shamo. Ki lele ino, omo na kamera. Mu juba ye toto a ye a kamera. Jedi saying, they call me I'm so decent, all the ladies feel me. They say I make sense, oh yeah. I know they follow them, maybe gan lo di Twitter. Every ku yapa gan lo sojo elek ba shita. Awa ni gboro, awa tu ni peacemaker, igboro lo gawa. I know they form undertaker. O se pe gan, you know say no be today. Ozula ni mi mo de lenu do ba linde. Alapa we ke tu e shako lo ba de ki lo nje Gucci. Le gwe a kube. You understand now? Thank you very much. That's the boy doing the same.
Wow, that was quite hilarious. That's a very good rap, really. All the rhymes and stuff. So I'd like you to sing something gospel for me.
Yeah. Okay. I'm not a vocalist. I will rap also.
Okay. No problem.
I'll rap also. Okay. Oluwa shanu emi no. Come and go me Niger, come and go me Demino. You know, this life is not easy, and I'm praying everything I do is good, easy. You understand? I pray to God everything I do to be blessed. Father, bless me. You understand? Thank you very much. I can still go if you want me to keep on.
Okay, Father, bless me too.
Okay, Father, bless Core TV. Father, bless JD Saint. Okay. Father, bless Mr. Bright. So our future should be bright, it should be light. Higher than the sky, flying to America, to Jamaica, to Canada.
I'm jealous. You didn't mention my name.
Sorry.
Omotayo.
Yeah, okay.
It's not too late to add my name.
Okay, it's not too late. Omotayo. All your wheels, Mama Toayo.
Amen.
Temino de Matayo.
Amen.
Tiko Tibi Maolayo.
Amen.
Alright,
thank you so very much, Jay Decent. It was really nice having you. We just looked at, of course, his music career, how he's been managing. But of course, one thing we noticed about him is very optimistic and very hopeful about the future. And so we're just praying for JD Sen that in the next coming years, he actually hits it real big in the industry. Of course, this year.
Yeah.
Amen. So thank you too for joining us on the program called Digest Extra. Do well to join us next week for another exciting and wonderful segment of the program. My name is Omotayo Alo. And don't forget, ensure that you keep hope alive. In the face of austerity measures, there is need for you to hope. Bye for now. Mata mi no go sori.
bi gele won pe mi larin kajabata mo mi na kore nothing where be you sakataye for complain se what ti ri to ko lena si ara ro play won ni mo kere won ni ri ku mi ti ba se ba fe te ku wa pade jam ni mi won ni kin pull over ko mi le complete fire burn surrender kori ko si ri ti dollar la ku oge ni ma lo go won ko mi je ni sin bi e fo so ko olowo laye mo olobe lo lo ko talking ni rumo le mi je ko kin je bo oluwa ti so oni ki ma balo sati ra money oni ki ma se lo ologi ni ti je ke kule ya salo e de ni se fe ni ke e ma ba wa na
what crazy autocracy or what type of crazy is that except crazy
news making the headlines
like Maria it to carry criminals driving looters that are in government today.
Sometimes it gets confrontational.
Fuck you in the face.
Kill me, don't put words into my mouth.
Whatever it is that will bring our military to disrepute, I say to hell
on Cold Digest.
I want to know why I should be believing them.
Every weekday, we bring all of these together and take them to the court of public opinion.
Everybody have your right in Nigeria.
Where you are the judge.